Hello, Taurus. Welcome to your weekly forecast. Thank you guys so much for being here with me today. Your reading is coming out a little bit later than I had hoped, but I hope y'all will excuse me, pardon me, because yesterday was my birthday, so just riding the wave of good feels. So thank you guys so much for being here with me today. As you probably already know, we are changing things up a little bit as just a result of me getting tired of doing the weekly forecast the same old way with the same spread for the last, I don't know, 4 to 5 years. So I would like to continue doing weekly forecasts. So I did come up with a new spread. I hope you guys like it. It's the Earth, Wind, Fire spread. I'll just briefly explain it for you newcomers and those of you who are interested in knowing what the difference is. But I think it's going to be a nice change up for everyone here. Some people have already complained, though, about me and wanting to bring back the old spread. But for now, this is what we're doing. But just to briefly explain the spread itself, you can fast forward through this if you don't want to listen, but I will not be announcing this ever again. Just takes up too much time. But the Earth portion of the reading we're going to cover your work and career, your money and your finances, and then also we're going to look at your physical health for the week ahead. The Wind portion will primarily focus on communication. So what communications are coming in for you this week? What important events might be happening for you this week? And then how is your mental health over the next week? And then the last portion would be fire. We're going to look at your love and relationship sector, your romance sector, what's happening for you in both of those areas. I guess I divided them into two different categories because I tend to see different things when I use different words for love and relationships. Love and relationships is like if you're partnered or you have a significant other, or you just want to see what's happening, whether you're single or not, single or in partnership, what's happening with that person. And then the romance part would be, I guess, a little bit more like, how's your sex life? What's going on? What dynamics are happening for you? Is there someone new coming in, etc.? And then, how's your sex life? Taurus, I'm sure you guys would love to know how your sex life is. Venus is in Leo, so I think it's probably gonna be popping. I don't know, correct me if I'm wrong. And then for the last part, we're gonna see who or what is your ally coming in and who or what's going to challenge you this week. So that's basically it. Like I said, I'm not gonna like explain this ever again. I just wanted to transition the new spread in and let you guys know what's up. So all the decks I'm using are listed below, as well as my contact information. If you want to book a personal private tarot reading with me, you can definitely do that. Check out my website and scheduling page down there, also up in the right-hand corner. There's also a Groupon link down there. Y'all need to check that out. You can get some pretty good deals. I think my 30-minute readings are on sale. You can get up to 50% off. So if a 30-minute reading is $75 right now, you can get that for definitely half of that. So it's definitely worth your time to check out the Groupon. I've had a few of you come through already. I really appreciate it because private readings are kind of keeping me going right now. So thank you so much for those of you who did book a private reading with me. I truly appreciate it and hope you continue to enjoy listening to these tarot readings as they come out. So let's go ahead and jump into this Taurus. If you can watch this reading, if you are a Taurus sun, moon, or rising, Taurus on the house cusp, if you have your sun in the second house or Venus in Taurus, you can watch this reading. If you are on the house cusp as well, or if you have your north node in Taurus or your north node in the second house, you can watch this reading. So that pretty much covers all my bases. Oh, I noticed this candle just went out here. I got to go get some more today. That reminds me, but at least we have this one going because I just relit this one. All right, let's see. What's coming in for Taurus this week, Spirit, in terms of their work and career situation? What's coming in for Taurus this week in terms of work and career? What can they expect? I'm looking for two cards here. Well, that's three cards. We do have the Star. Nice. The Hierophant, that's your card, Taurus. And we have the Five of Swords. So some of you are influencers. Some of you are in the spotlight. Some of you have social media channels, YouTube channels. I definitely see that. Some of you are like celebrities. Okay. I definitely see someone here who could be doing something with teaching. Definitely, I'm doing, or a spiritual guru. You could be a tarot reader on here, or someone that has a following. Yeah, this week you have some conflict coming in with the Five of Swords. I feel like if you're dealing with an Aquarius this week, they might have some sort of rivalry with you. This could be words and speech, someone coming in here, leaving a nasty comment, or fortunately, I don't see too many of those these days, but, if you're a star with the Hierophant here, you could definitely have a following. So, you know, people could just be hateful. People could just be hating. All I can say is just turn the comments off or focus on your craft or, believe in your passion. You know, don't listen to the haters. The only reason they're doing that is because they're jealous. They hate us because they ain't us, right? So, all right. So that's looking good, but that's just a little heads up there for you, all you Tauruses out there who have are YouTubers or you have a following. Obviously, with the Hierophant here, you're trying to do the right thing. You are upholding your spiritual and moral values. You have good, strong ethics. You're a teacher. People are learning from you. So I don't know what the Five of Swords is here other than someone coming in and feeling jealous or someone in feeling hateful. Ignore them is all I can say. So what's going on with your money and finances this week? Taurus, money and finances. Too many cards. I saw the Ten of Cups there. What's going on for Taurus in terms of their money and finances this week? Wheel of Fortune, growth, expansion, and change. Things will not be staying the same here. There's a shift happening, and we have the King of Wands. Nice. Okay, so you could have a fire sign coming in here that's going to change things for you. You could be calling this person in. I heard patron. So this could be someone. I see $50. This could be $500. Someone here wants to patronize you. I also feel like you are heading towards a leadership position here. So I'm also hearing taking the lead. Yeah, but your destiny here is the King of Wands. So there's some action being taken. I really feel like some of you are going to be getting paid as well. I see a payment coming in. I see $50 here. So someone could be, this could be a fire sign coming in and giving you $50 for something that you're doing. Maybe it's more than that though. But I feel like things are moving in a good direction. If you've been wondering about a promotion here at work, I feel like there's a good chance that you will be promoted. Because I see someone here who's taking the lead, who's taking action on something. Clarify the King of Wands, though. Clarify the King of Wands here for money and finances. Oh, this is a strong leader energy. Also, Leo coming in. Seven of Pentacles. Well, this is waiting for results, waiting for a return on investment here. Someone is being patient as well. I feel like this is an investor for some of you. Someone could be investing their time, their money, their energy into your business or into your finances. Or someone, like I said, this is someone that is taking stock here. So maybe this is you, though, because I'm sort of seeing someone here who's going over their ledger. You are going to be seeing results. Not everything is ready yet, though. Some things have to mature. If you have like a portfolio or something of things that you do or stocks or whatever, I feel like they're doing well, but they are like, this is kind of like one of those things where they need time to invest and grow. How is Taurus's physical health this week? How is Taurus's physical health? Show me. How is Taurus's physical health this week? The Hanged Man, stagnant, not moving, kind of stuck. And we have the Four of Swords resting. Yeah, not a whole lot of movement here. Maybe you're feeling lethargic. Maybe you are just hanging out this week. I feel like This is a week where maybe you're catching up on rest or sleep. Maybe things have been pretty chaotic lately. But I also see someone using one of those, what are they called? I can't think of the name of it at the moment, where you hang upside down and it stretches out all your muscles and your back. It's really a chiropractic tool. This could be a good week to go to the chiropractor, or if you want to get a massage, or maybe do yoga or something where you can stretch out, calisthenics, things like that. Otherwise, it looks a little bit stagnant. It looks a little bit like there's not a whole lot of movement. If you want to get moving, those are some good ideas, especially this time of year. Okay. Let's see what's coming in terms of your communications this week. Who or what is going to be communicating with you? What kind of messages can you expect coming in? And then we'll look at your events and your mental health. Show me, Taurus, communications. What can they expect in terms of communications this week? Taurus, communications. One more here. Show me Taurus. Communications this week. What can I expect? Princess of Swords. That's Gemini's energy. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. And we have Queen of Deaths, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. That's you. Okay. So maybe some harsh communication this week. Princess of Swords. She's kind of swinging that sword around willy-nilly. So be careful here, because I'm hearing something about harsh judgments or harsh words. You are looking good. You are looking fine. Someone else could be defending you in some matter here. You might be receiving some communications here through a third party as well. You might overhear something. You might see something. I'm just noticing the smoke and there's a lot of the sword is moving around a lot. So maybe it's just idle chatter, but I feel like we need to pay attention to things like tone. How are we coming off to others? This is more immature energy. This is mature energy. Okay. Yeah, I definitely hear someone's going to be hearing some news or getting some news. It might not be the greatest news. It might be something that you overhear, like I said. Show me what's happening. What events are taking place for Taurus this week? What events are taking place for Taurus this week? What events are taking place for Taurus? Those tumbled out. We do have Eight of Cups, Indolence, and that is Saturn in Pisces. We have the Four of Cups, Luxury. That's Cancer's energy. Change, Jupiter in Capricorn. And we have the Star, Aquarius. Okay, very nice. So yeah, I feel like you or someone else is walking away from a situation that has gone a little bit lazy, a little bit complacent. We're taking for granted our blessings. There is going to be some changes here. Now, these are incremental changes that will take place over a long period of time. They are moving you in a direction of healing. And also, like I said, with the star here and the star here for your work, this is showing me that you are moving into your rightful place in the world in terms of your work and career. If you've always wanted to be an influencer, if you've always wanted to be in the spotlight, if you've always wanted to have some sort of online presence, I guess, or even to be in a healing profession, You are moving in that direction, but you're going to have to leave behind maybe some habits here. You're being nudged in a positive direction, is what I'm seeing here. Now, if this is someone else leaving you behind, it's because they're being called to do something else with their life. Okay, they have a destiny. The star talks about your destiny, your fate, your north node. Okay, so you are moving in that direction, or they are. And it's for the best, is what I want to say. Show me Taurus's mental health this week. Show me Taurus's mental health. What can they expect in terms of their mental health this week? The devil and the moon. Well, the first thing I heard was bipolar, but I also do get some sort of mental disorder or obsession here. Definitely some deep psychological stuff going on. We have Capricorn and Pisces here. Now, someone could have a sex addiction. That's one thing coming through here. Someone could have a porn addiction. Someone could definitely have some illusions or delusional thinking here. I have to be careful because this is the shadow. This is the subconscious, conscious self here. So this is like the unexplored shadow part of our personality. And the devil represents obsessive thinking, controlling. You might be trying to control this aspect of your subconscious, but I feel like it's wanting to express itself somehow. This is something that there's some toxicity here as well in terms of your mental state. All right. I'm getting particularly if you're a masculine watching, this is something you need to be aware of. Someone here might be getting therapy for this, or might need to go into therapy for this, is what I'm seeing. All right, let's look at your love and relationships this week. What's happening for Taurus in terms of their love and relationship sector? What can they expect? Love and relationships, Taurus. We do have trust, the solar plexus chakra. Seek the truth and rest and reconsider. Okay. Some of you are dealing with a Pisces. I also see Gemini's energy here, Aquarius's energy here, Leo's energy is here, and Libra is here. You could be dealing with any of those signs this week. So for your love and relationships, the trust, solar plexus, seek the truth, rest and reconsider. Some of you are feeling adventurous. Obviously, there's an activation going on here with the Lionsgate portal activation and also Leo season. You know, Leo rules the solar plexus chakra, your creativity, your self-esteem. You can see here. Also, this is the seat of your wisdom and power. Feeling a new sense of freedom here. There's something that you need to investigate further. Okay, you also want to find the truth about something. Someone could be looking into you. I heard looking into your past. Someone is definitely trying to. This is a mental energy. It can also indicate a deception. Someone wants to peel back the layers here and see who is underneath this mask. Rest and reconsider. Someone is definitely feeling worn out here. Someone is feeling like they need time because they lack the resources to go further. This guy is like ascending this hill here. I sort of see him as a mountain climber or like a, what do you call it? Someone that scales, someone that does the with the ropes and everything. So maybe you like doing that kind of sport, but what I'm seeing here for your love and relationships is there is a new beginning. But I feel like there's something that there's something that you're doing that is deceptive, and they want you to possibly go within here or get more information. If you're dealing with someone else here, you may not know this person as well as you think you do. And that's why you're feeling a little bit worn out, is what I'm getting from this. That you need to get more information. Also, someone could be doing a background check here. Someone could be doing something on social media, trying to gather evidence, gather information. Someone could be doing something behind the scenes here that's deceptive. We have Aries, Leo, Aquarius, and Sagittarius here. You could be dealing with any of those signs as well. Show me what's happening for romance this week for Taurus. Show me romance. Romance. What's coming in for Taurus in terms of romance? Finances and career. Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now. So whether you're aware of it or not, you or someone you're dealing with are struggling in their career, and finances might be a factor here. So that means that that's a priority right now for you or this person. Romance may not be a priority for you or this person. Okay, someone needs to straighten out their financial situation. Healing family issues, your love life benefits as you forgive your parents. So this can go back to a family situation here, particularly with someone's dad. I'm seeing someone that has a sibling as well. There could be sibling rivalry or daddy issues, father issues. Those things are taking precedence right now for you or the person that you're dealing with. If it doesn't apply to you, then it doesn't apply to you because I don't know you. I don't know your story. I was going to say, who is your ally this week? The Desert Princes, Survival, False Promises. How is this an ally spirit? The Hawk Prince, spirit communication, paying attention. Okay. Spirit is trying to get something across to you. They want to see if you're paying attention. Okay. They also want you to get a higher perspective on a matter. You're going to be receiving some communication this week. Your ally could definitely also be a fire sign here, a younger fire sign. I definitely see a younger Leo. And I'm seeing a younger Leo masculine energy. Now, this person is definitely lying about something here. They're promising you something that's never going to happen. This person is consumed by survival. So their root chakra is really not stable. They need to do root work here. Root chakra work, not root work, root chakra work. They want you to believe something that's not true. And so that's why spirit is coming in to communicate with you. They're testing you this week to see how are you going to believe this person, or are you going to believe your intuition? Are you going to listen to your intuition? I know that was a little bit of a tricky one, okay? Because this person looks like an ally, but I don't feel like they're kind of like they're kind of playing. They're playing here. They're playing you. The Hawk Prince is not, though. The Hawk Prince is saying spirit is communicating you through this person, communicating to you through this person. Are you going to believe this person, or are you going to believe spirit? Are you going to listen to your higher self? Are you going to have a higher perspective on this matter? Or are you going to fall for this dummy? And this could be an aspect of yourself as well coming through. Show me who or what is going to challenge you this week, even though I feel like that's kind of a challenge. He's an ally because if it's an aspect of your personality, he wants you to survive. He wants you to find a way to survive. Obviously, we have to survive in this matrix. We have to survive in the 3D, right? But it's not going to happen through promising something that would never happen. You cannot lie your way through the situation. False promises. For example, this could be someone that is constantly like telling people that they have this great job or this, you know, they really are, they do this or whatever for work, but really they're unemployed and they don't have anything going on for them. So people are going to start, I don't know. I don't know if I believe you. You know, what do you believe about yourself? Maybe this is someone that is a compulsive liar as well, you could be dealing with here. Show me. Who or what is going to challenge you this week, Taurus? Who or what is going to challenge you? Second house resources. Well, that's your house. The second house is ruled by Taurus. So we see it here, finances and career. So you are needing to align something with your authentic purpose, with what you're doing, how you're making money here. There's a fire sign coming in here that if this is like an investor or someone that is a business partner, there's something here that they want to see results with, and you or they are lying about or promising something that's never going to happen. So your challenge this week is going to be around your resources, your money and your wealth, and also your finances and your career. There's something going on there that ain't right. So Taurus, this is what I have for you. You know, I actually, let's get one more. I won't leave you guys on that note. Fifth house, passion. Yeah. You may love to do something, but it's not bringing in the income right now. So you may need to think about what other resources you can find to make money right now. Maybe you need to pick up a second job. Maybe this hobby isn't as lucrative as you thought it was going to be. Something here, or something needs to be a hobby and stay a hobby. And if you're putting a lot of money into it, it's no longer a hobby. It's become something else. And so stop lying to yourself about what it really is. That's what I have for you, Taurus. Thank you so much for tuning in. This is your weekly forecast. I will see you guys back real soon. Bye.